Hello! In this video, I will show you how to create a SharePoint workflow that will pull data from an XML source. We will use native SharePoint components and custom actions added by HarePoint Workflow Extensions. Available for SharePoint 2010 and 2013 workflow platforms, including SharePoint Online. Let's imagine that we have a task to add up-to-date euro exchange rates to our system. The European Central Bank hosts a special XML file that holds daily exchange rates for euro against major currencies. That is why we will pull the required data from it. Let's open the SharePoint Designer and create a new site workflow. Now, let's open the Actions tab. Here, we will find hundreds of amazing actions added by HarePoint Workflow Extensions. Let's find the Network category and select the Send HTTP GET Request action. It will allow us to receive the content of the specified XML file. Let's paste the link to the XML file. The pulled data will be stored in the variable called response. Processing our HTTP GET request, the server will also send us a status code that will let us know if the request has been processed successfully or not. That response will be stored as a variable called status code, and we need to confirm that it is 200. That means that the file has been fetched and is transmitted. To do so, we will use the condition if any value equals value. To confirm if the status code is equal to 200 before moving forward. We have successfully pulled data from the server and into our variable. Now, let's convert it into something useful. We open the Development category and add the Transform XML action. It will allow us to convert received data to HTML using an XSLT style sheet. Let's set the variable called response that holds the content of the XML file as the first parameter. The XSLT style sheet for this example can be found in the HarePoint blog using the link below. This content, transformed to HTML, is going to be stored in the variable called HTMLData. And that's it! We have successfully created a workflow that will pull data from an XML file and store it as an HTML table. Now, let's create a file with the currency exchange rates. We open the Documents Library category and add Create Document from Text. We point the action to get the text from the variable called HTMLData. And set the new file to be saved as rates.aspx in the Shared Documents folder. Important step! Make sure to run the workflow with the necessary SharePoint permissions. Also, every time we will launch the workflow, the file will be overwritten with the latest exchange rates. As a final touch, let's add a proper end to our workflow. Good. Let's save, publish, and test the workflow. And the workflow completed successfully. Let's open the Shared Documents folder and check the new file with the currency exchange rates. With the help of a simple web part, we will be able to embed this info to any page. I hope you found this video helpful. If you would like to learn more about our workflow extension, please check out our other videos or download a free 30-day trial from our website. We can also schedule for a demo session and show you the product in details, answering all your questions live. Thank you for your time.